I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please pause for a moment of silence.
Today is Friday, February 14th, 2020. Valentine's Day! Make sure to get something for your significant other. And here is your news of the day.
Teachers, it is time to get the names of students who don't have a bus pass for this afternoon. Students, please raise your hand now. Teachers, please send a message to Ms. Moreno with the names of students who need a pass for today. These passes will be in your mailbox by lunchtime for teachers to pick up and distribute to students in time for dismissal. Thank you.
Students, please remember that school starts at 7:45 every day. It is important to be on time and get your full day of instruction. If you are constantly late, you are cheating yourself out of education and consequences will be assigned. So let your parents know and we'll see you Monday by 7:45. Same fact of the day. Here's another amazing technology that has totally changed our world for the better. Solar cells. Solar cells convert light energy to electricity. The photovoltaic effect was first demonstrated by Becquerel in 1839. It has recently achieved a level of almost 45% efficiency. So basically, it's taking light, solar light, and making it into energy. A 5x5 feet solar cell could be screwed to the side of your house and meet all of your energy needs.
Okay. Caddy cars, teachers, please be handing out caddy cars so we can recognize people like Camila in second grade was goodness by Miss Iron for being responsible. Kaylani in fourth grade was goodness by Miss Birch for being responsible. Destiny in kindergarten was given us by Miss Hardy for being respectful. Amy in third grade was given us by Mrs. Sika for being responsible. Cindy in first grade was given us by Miss Parker for being responsible. Jimmy in eighth grade was given us by Miss Bells for being responsible and respectful. Adriana in fifth grade was given us by Miss Cleaver for being respectful. Liz F. In sixth grade was given us by Miss Ira for showing caddy pride. And Hunk in seventh grade was given us by Mr. Conover for showing caddy pride. Students, if I call your name, please go to Miss Barrett's office so you can get your prize.
Birthdays on Valentine's Day. Today's celebrating birthday is Isalina Gonzalez. Happy birthday.
Caddy Howler of the Week. For today's Kelly Heller of the Week, we got the chance to catch up with another successful story here at Caddy Ridge.
Thanks, guys. Here we are at Mr. Sika's computer lab to talk with Jacqueline, James, and Adeline, who are all proficient on the new second grade quarterly formative assessment in reading. Can I talk with you guys?
Yes.
Okay. Guys, congratulations on this achievement. As second graders, this is your first time taking a test like this. How were you guys so successful on the test?
We looked back at the passage and we eliminated two questions and then we did a straight line and a squiggle line and then we did the right answer.
And the next question is, can you give any students tips on becoming more successful when they're taking like these reading tests?
Well, when you look back at the story, it's gonna be more challenging at the first time. But when you look back at the story, it's not gonna be challenging anymore. So you can figure it out really quick.
What about you, Jacqueline?
I just read a lot, and it helped me well.
All right. Thanks, guys, for being on the show. Now let's head back to the studio.
We are back in the new studio. That was a very successful start. And remember to always be respectful, responsible, and safe. But most of all, stay with us. Coyote pride is hard to hide. We'll see you next week, and also have a wonderful week. Bye.
Yeah.
Start again from the top, though. The whole thing.
Okay.
Don't say okay. Try not to say okay.
Okay.
Ready. Raise a little thing all over.